going on, everybody? Welcome to another episode of Junior's World of Soul. I am back with a new video representing R&B the right way, the authentic way. But before y'all do anything, listen, it's all about R&B. Like this video, share it, subscribe to Junior's World of Soul. Look, man, I'm here fighting for R&B, man. I'm here to do it the right way, the authentic way. Come on, man. I came in with Lucky Day. I'm grooving to this joint. This joint is dope. Buying time, Lucky Day. One of the most promising artists when it comes to R&B music. Like, he's that dope, you know what I mean? But listen, y'all, I don't want to keep y'all too long this video, you know what I'm saying? But I want to talk about something first. I do want y'all, listen, I have my music thoughts that I talk about on Twitter all the time. So follow me on Twitter. It's Music with a K, Soul Nick, as in New York Nick. And Junior World of Soul on IG. I'll put everything in the more info box for real, y'all. Like, I be having music thoughts that a lot of times I don't be talking about in the video. And I want y'all to go back and forth with me, converse with me. You know what I'm saying? Send me a shout out. Say, hey, what's up? You know what I mean? Tell me, yo, I enjoyed the video and all that good stuff. But like I said, I don't want to keep y'all too long. But if you're new to Junior's World of Soul, this is Current R&B Bangers. Current R&B Bangers is all about showing mainstream the R&B is alive and well, and it's here, y'all, you know what I'm saying, and it ain't going nowhere. And since 2016, I wanted to create something to just show, you know, everybody that R&B is dying. It's so sad that, Teddy Riley was on, what is it, V103 in Atlanta, and he did a video, and you saw so many people saying R&B is dead, R&B is dead, and me and our bro Sim was looking at these comics, and we was just like, yo, like, y'all really bugging out. Like, R&B is here. It's alive and well. Like, what are y'all talking about? You know what I mean? So, for me, you know what I'm saying? I started putting my, you know, videos under there. You know, my brother really started letting people know, check out Junior's World of Soul. You know what I'm saying? Because he talks about R&B. You know what I'm saying? We need a lot more platforms to really show that R&B is alive and well. And I'm talking about, you know, I got to give a shout out to You Know I Got Soul. I got to give a shout out to This Is R&B, Rated R&B Singers Room, that really, really talks about R&B and not fake with it. You know what I'm saying? Like, these big publications that just use R&B when it's hot for the moment. You know what I mean? So really have to shout out those. Y'all know I gotta go on a little rant before, you know, I get into the video. But listen, this Current R&B Bangers, y'all, I got 5 joints for y'all this week. You know what I'm saying? I'm representing the fellas this week. It's all about the dudes this week. You know what I'm saying? As y'all can see, I came in with Lucky Day, Buying Time. You know what I'm saying? But this one is really, really all about the fellas. So let's get this started. So Yeah, Mr. Robin Thicke, Mr. Robin Thicke. Now, I'm gonna have to say something a little bit. Now, I was a fan of Robin Thicke. I was a big fan of this dude. But when the whole Blurred Lines came, I loved the record. I ain't even gonna stunt. I love Blurred Lines. It was like the song of 2013, of the summer of 2013. He came with it. But as a soul fan, I knew when I heard it, I'm sorry, I heard Gotta Give It Up. So when all the controversy happened, it was like, come on, we didn't know this. You know what I'm saying? I remember when I talked to my mom and I called her on the phone and I was like, you heard Robin Thicke's new song? And she was like, yeah, I heard it. You talking about the Marvin Gaye sample that you? I ain't even say nothing. You know what I'm saying? So after all the controversy, you know what I'm saying? Even though the song was hot, if they would have just gave some credit, it would have been all good. They wouldn't have to worry about it. But that's neither here nor there. But Robin Thicke, you know, I've been following him since he was thick, y'all. Before he put the Robin in it, but he was just thick. Dude with the long hair, riding in the video, just on a bike, riding through New York. That's when I was a fan of him, you know what I'm saying? But if you don't know Robin Thicke, he really, really made his career really as more of a songwriter in the beginning, because he wrote for Brandy, A Love on My Side, which is the anniversary of her. Her album actually was released 25 years ago last week. And he wrote Love on My Side. You know, he was down with Brian McKnight, because Brian McKnight actually really saw him as a dope artist, you know what I mean? And then after that, you know, if you don't know, his father is Allen up there from Growing Pains, the show Growing Pains. So that was his pops, you know what I'm saying? So he actually took a different route, you know what I'm saying? He really, really was inspired by soul music. And after a while, he got his deal. He came out with Beautiful World in 2002. And it kind of got him noticed a little bit. They tried to throw him in the neo-soul type of category, which I kind of hate that they gave it that name, but that's neither here nor there. But then in 2006 is kind of when Robin really, really got noticed by the mainstream, and really people started really paying attention to him. And that's with the evolution of Robin Thicke. And that was with the big song, Lost Without You. Even though he had a couple joints before he came out with Lost Without You. But then after that, he came out with the what else did he come out with? I'm trying to think. Something Else, which my song was Magic, and that video was funny. That was a funny video because Robin was dancing and all that kind of stuff, so I thought that was dope. Then he came out with Blurred Lines, and then that controversy happened and all that stuff, but it was a big, big record. Like, Robin Thicke had the summer of 2013 on lock with that record. You know what I mean? It was so crazy. I remember when they played that song at one of my best friends' wedding, Alicia's, like, we was jamming to that joint. That's how big the joint was, you know what I'm saying? But then after that, it kind of went kind of downhill after the controversy, and then, you know, the infidelity with him and Paula, which ain't got nothing to do. But then he brought out his album Paula, and nobody really listened to it. Everybody was like, Robin, what the heck is this? And then after that, he started coming out with singles that I enjoy. I enjoyed Morning Sun. I enjoyed the deep joint that he had with Nas. And then Testify was also a good joint. And I think Robin got back to the basis of what we loved about him. He was that balladeer. He was the person that we wanted to, you know what I'm saying? Blurred Line was cool, but I think everybody really loved that Lost Without You. You know what I'm saying? We wanted that. And he started giving us back that. And then in 2019, this song that you hear in the background was That's What Love Can Do. This song was actually number one on the R&B charts, and it was huge for him. And we love this type of music, you know what I'm saying? And for me, I'm like, Robin, give me this, you know what I'm saying? You will always have Blurred Lines, which is, you know, all good, even though you gotta give some of your money to the gay family, rightfully so. But he got back to what we loved about him, sitting in front of that piano and just singing us the ballads. You know what I mean? But now, you know, Robin has been remarried and everything, all that good stuff. And, you know, now he's on the dope show, Masked Singer. I think that show is so dope because it's like, we know, you know, the people that watch it be like, oh, we know who it is. But a lot of, you know, the panel is him, it's Robin and Nicole from the Pussycat Dolls, and Jenny McCarthy, and I forgot what the other dude name is. But it's so funny how they be calling out these names. You be like, Robin, come on, dog. Like, you sang with some of these people, you know what I'm saying? Like, they know you, and you be saying the wrong artist. But I think it's such a dope show. But now Robin has a new song out that I love when I heard it, and I was like, yeah, I'm gonna talk about this joint, you know what I mean? I think, again, it's the Robin that we really love and that we really enjoy, and the song is entitled When You Love Someone, and it's a beautiful record, and I definitely wanted to talk about it. So here's the first joint of current R&B bangers. This is coming from Robin Thicke, and this is When You Love Somebody. Here we go.
Cause when you love somebody, you need somebody, no need to fight it, so help me help you.
When you love somebody, you need somebody,
we'll be somebody,
hey.
So help me help you.
I don't care.
Like, it still has that, it kind of gotta have a little groove to it, but it still got that flavor that we love from Robin, that little smooth flavor, you know what I'm saying? I think it's a dope record. Listen, anybody can connect to it. When you love somebody, you need somebody. Yeah, I like that joint. I just like the melody of the record, you know what I mean? But listen, When You Love Somebody is all on streaming platforms. Check it out. You know what I'm saying? Go back and listen to, you know, Robin Thicke's old music. You know what I'm saying? And check it out and realize that Robin been doing this for years. You know what I'm saying? So he definitely deserves his credit for getting by all the controversy. But this song right here is dope, and that's why I wanted to talk about it. So this is the first joint of current R&B bangers. This is Robin Thicke with When You Need Love Somebody. You need somebody. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Alrighty, alright. Ooh. Hey. Ah. Smooth, 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 smooth. Talking about, that's coming in with my boy Calvin Richardson. Calvin Richardson, I am a fan of this dude. I'm a big old fan. I'm sorry, y'all. There was a phone call that came in. Listen, whoever this is, you know I'm recording. I'm sorry. But, you know, Calvin Richardson, if you don't know who he is, Calvin Richardson is just, they call him the Prince of Soul. You know what I'm saying? They do. He was in a group, and then after that, he left the group, and in 99, he became his solo artist, and he came out with his first album, Country Boy. And then in 2003, he came out with an album, 2:35 p.m., was the day that when one of his kids was born. That's how he titled it. And then after that, he came out with When Love Comes. Then he came with the Bobby tribute album, Bobby Womack tribute album. Then America's Most Wanted. And then I Am Calvin. And then the last album, All or Nothing, that I talked about on current R&B bangers. Now, Calvin Richardson has become a member of my family for so many reasons. Because first of all, when my mom heard him on WBLS, on Wendy used to be on WBLS, y'all, she, listen, y'all think Wendy was shady then, now, she was worse on the radio, but my mom was a faithful listener of her radio show, so one day my mom heard, what song did she hear, Falling In and Out of Love, she heard that song by Calvin, and it's called Falling Out, and she was like, oh, I like this, let me go buy it, so she actually brought it home, and we listened to it, and my whole family loved it, and to know that he was from the South, that made it even better, because, you know, my family's roots are from the South, so, you know, we was like, yo, he from the South too, and then when you hear his music, you hear that soul, you can tell he's from the South, you know what I mean, and then he gave us that Bobby Womack flavor, so we called him Bobby Womack Jr., and then after he did the tribute album to Bobby Womack, which we thought was dope, we was like, we knew what we were talking about, when we heard that voice, we heard that soul in him, we heard that Bobby Womack in him, you know what I mean, and that's why, again, they call him the king of, not the king, but the prince of soul, for real, and then another reason, my mom thinks he looks good, like, me and her did a video maybe about 2.5 years ago, and we talked about Calvin Richardson, and my mom went on this long rant for like 5 minutes about Calvin Richardson, talking about how good he looks, and Calvin actually saw the video and actually posted my mom talking about the dude, and I'm just looking at her like, okay, when is this gonna be done? Okay, Calvin, you my dude for real, but my mom was talking about your looks, and I was like, okay, enough, you know what I mean? But he has a new joint out, which, one thing about Calvin, he's talking to the ladies, and why not? You know what I'm saying? Respect to him, you know what I'm saying? And he got a new joint out, it's called Let Me Love You, Let Me Love On You. That sounds like a Southern joint, Let Me Love Up On You, you know what I'm saying? Like, Calvin brings that Southern to his music just because he's from the South, and then he has that soul, you know what I mean? So, I think it was dope, it was smooth, and I think my mom would probably be pissed if I didn't talk about it, but the song is dope, you know what I'm saying, but I can't wait till my mom to hear it, because I know she gonna go off about it, you know what I'm saying, so here's the second joint of current R&B bangers, this is coming from Calvin Richardson, and this is Let Me Love Up On You, so here we go, sounds good, y'all.
Let me love on you. Let me love on you.
Hey.
Make it do
right there. You can't help. I can see my South Carolina family hearing this song, and we in the yard, and they frying some good old fish. You know what I'm saying? And we in the yard, and we just grooming to it. You know what I'm saying? This seemed like a joint where you gotta have a drink in your hand and just sway from side to side. Calvin know what's up. You know what I mean? But this joint is dope. It's smooth. You know what I'm saying? Calvin always brings it. He keeps that soul in his music. He's an artist that's really overlooked, but y'all need to check Calvin out. He's dope, man, and he sticks to his R&B roots, and he gets respect here. So definitely the song is dope. Let Me Love Up On You is on all streaming platforms now. Check Calvin out, and that's the second joint on current R&B bangers.
All right, all right. Let Me Love On You. Alrighty, alrighty. Who we coming with next?
Oh!
I'm a sucker for your body.
Hey, 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 yes, yes, yes! I don't care what nobody say, he is one of the underrated legendary artists. Stokely is an artist, y'all. Like, yeah, you might know him from Mint Condition and all that good stuff, yes. But this dude has worked with everybody. Like, check the credits. He done worked with Janet Jackson. He worked with Gladys Knight, Luther, Usher. The list just goes on and on and on. Kelly Price. It's so many people he has worked with. And don't get me wrong, you know what I'm saying? Mint Condition, who is one of my second favorite male 90s groups, because I feel like they are so under the radar, but they are not really a group, they're a band. They are really, really a band. You know what I'm saying? They play them instruments. They are dope. You know what I'm saying? But I feel like they get really, really overlooked. You know what I'm saying? So I was so happy when I got to go see them in concert, and they bodied it. You know what I'm saying? I never seen when Pretty Brown Eyes came on, and like the beat, just the drums came in, and the crowd lost it. You talking about people from the ages of 30 to like 60 is in BB King's going crazy. Like, that's how dope it was. And Stokely is an artist. That dude can sing, he can play percussion, he can play drums, he can do all that. Like, he's so underrated, and I hate it that he really, really is. You know what I mean? But he finally, after so long, came out with a solo album that you hear in the background. The song is Level on Introducing Stokely. I talked about a couple of these joints of current R&B bangers. I talked about Level. I talked about Organic. I talked about Think About You. Another favorite of mine was Art in the Motion with Robert Gunn. Hold My Breath, Way Up, and Be With You. Those were favorites of mine, you know what I'm saying? And please, y'all, like, my brother Sin called that junk a classic when he heard it. You know what I mean? And a lot of people use that classic word a little too strong these days, but when it comes to music, people like me and my bro, if he says it's a classic, recommend you guys check out Introducing Stokely. It is a dope, dope album. I really, really recommend it. But The Legend has a new song, and I found this out because I follow Stokely, and I follow Jimmy Jam and Terry Lewis, but Terry Lewis on his Twitter was talking about it. I was like, wait, hold on, rewind. He got another record? Are you kidding me? What's going on? So, I heard the record, I love it. That's why I was like, I'm gonna talk about it on current R&B bangers, absolutely. This record is entitled She, and it's with Vu. I hope I'm pronouncing it right, V-U. And I think it's dope, and Stokely is giving you the vibes. It's like, to me, it's like, I'm ready for this, because it's like, it's still giving me favors of Introducing Stokely, but I know he gonna give me something, you know, different. And because he's a dope artist, again, Stokely is a dope artist. But anyway, I can go all day. But here is She, and this is by Stokely, so here we go.
She is a queen of mine, she's perfectly designed, she's without even trying to live.
the moves of that joint. Come on. Hey, that joint go in, y'all. Like, it's a groove. Stokely, it, like, level. Gave, you know what I'm saying? Gives you that, you know, a little bit of that trap, a little bit. But this joint gives you that. That R&B flavor, you know what I'm saying? Like that R&B flavor, no trap in it, but it still got a groove to it. Like, how can you not remember a song like this? Like, come on, like the song is that dope. You know what I'm saying? Damn, my throat all dry because I'm so happy talking about the song. Hold on. Okay, had to get it together. But yes, y'all, song is dope. As y'all can see, I'm grooving to it. I really, really love the record. That's why I definitely wanted to talk about it. But she is on all streaming platforms. Please support this record. Please support Stokely. And if you need confirmation, please go back and listen to Mid Condition. I'm trying to tell y'all, they are a dope band. They are just dope musicians. You know what I'm saying? Even Prince loves Stokely. That's how much it, and come on, that's enough to be said. Prince don't just fool with any old body. And he rock with Stokely. You know what I'm saying? So please, y'all. She is on all streaming platforms. That's by Stokely. And that's the third joint on current R&B bangers. Woo! I'm getting all spat and all that because of that joint. That's how much I really rock with Stokely for real. But okay. Okay. We got somebody new. I love finding new artists and talking about it on current R&B bangers. Now, this artist, his name is Dayton James. And Dayton is, he's representing the UK, but he's living in Toronto. And it's just crazy to think that when you're hearing an artist's music, you never really know their biography. And when you read it, it really makes you be like, wow, that's crazy. Because this was a dude that really loved to sing and it was an outlet, but he didn't do it because he didn't think it was cool. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't cool. So he really didn't want it to be known. But finally, you know, Faye had it because his mom put out a video on YouTube and it just like blew up for him. You know what I'm saying? You can't help what you're supposed to be doing. You know what I'm saying? And then after people started finding out the dude sing, then all of a sudden like, yo, you sing? And I'm like, wow. You know what I mean? The things that people say that ain't cool. Let me tell you something. If I still had my nice singer voice, let me tell you something. I'd be woo all over the place. You know what I'm saying? Like, no, ma'am, sir, we not doing that. Okay. But after that, you know, he started getting a little exposure, and then he got a publishing deal. So he started writing for a lot of different artists, and he started writing for people like Shaggy and a lot of other artists. And this song is kind of like the first joint that I think he released that you hear in the background. And it's entitled "Change My Ways," and this joint got a little knock to it. You know what I'm saying? But the song that really got me is the song that I'm going to talk about, and this song is entitled "Already Won." Now this song, Already Won, I love when I, you know, read the interview that he did for it. He said when he wrote this record, he said that this is close to the heart because he felt really unfulfilled as an artist. You know what I'm saying? You writing for other people and you're giving them these songs, but it's like you don't feel, you're not fulfilled, but then you kind of look at your life and be like, you know what, I'm winning. You know what I'm saying? Just because I'm not the one that has my name and lights and all that, but I'm doing something that I love, so I already won. And I said, wow, that's inspiring. You know what I'm saying? And also for somebody like me, because I'm an emotional listener. So when I heard Already Won, I said, this is from somewhere from his heart or something. This happened to him or something, because you hear it in the music. You hear the way he's singing. You know what I'm saying? And for me, it's kind of tough, especially when you're doing YouTube. And you feel like you're not getting the views that you want to do. And it's a little bit discouraging, but it's like anytime I get in front of this camera just to talk about R&B and feel like I'm doing a little something just to help try to show R&B is out here and it's alive and well, you know what I mean? It's just, I already won, and this song was very inspiring, and I was like, yo, I gotta talk about this, you know what I'm saying? And I think, you know, and his falsetto was nothing to play with, you know what I'm saying? We got a lot of people that can do some falsettos, you know what I'm saying, that can really do it, that don't need computers and don't need anything else. Yeah, I had to take the glasses off for that moment. But yeah, I just think the song is dope. Definitely had to talk about it. Give y'all a good sample of this record. So here is Already One, and this is from Dayton James. So here we go. Just listen to the words, y'all. Very, 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 very inspiring. Like, come on, people, that's inspiration. Maybe he might have wrote it from a different place, but for me, when I listen to the song, listen, if you doing something you love, I know it's hard out there, I understand. You be like, you feel like nobody's listening, nobody's paying attention, but listen, when you doing something that you love, you already won. You know what I mean? And that's how this song really, really got me. And I love just finding new artists, you know what I'm saying? Because we got real artists out here that's really, really doing it for the R&B culture, and they not getting the love that they deserve. So anytime I find a new artist right here on Current R&B Bangers, I'm always gonna talk about them, you know what I'm saying? So this joint is entitled Already One. This is by Dayton James, and yeah, that's Already One, and that's the fourth joint on Current R&B Bangers. So support this dude. I'm gonna put all his info in the more info box, for real. For support these new R&B artists, man. I think y'all wanna know that one. Hey, hey, that is coming from the boy Gallant. Now, you don't know Gallant, he was born in D.C., but he was raised in Columbia, Maryland, which is maybe about 20 minutes from here, you know what I'm saying? And this dude was inspired by Brandy, he was inspired by Tony Braxton, Babyface, and then he was inspired by Radiohead and a lot of rock artists. And when you listen to Gallant's music, you can tell why. You know what I'm saying? You can understand why. Not tell why. You can understand why. And then after this, you know, after high school and all that good stuff, Gallant went to NYU, and he brought out his first EP entitled Zebra. And like I said, you can definitely tell the R&B and the rock influences all in that album. Songs like Manhattan, Sirens, Ibuprofen, and Forfeit. Forfeit is actually my favorite. That's track number two. And from reading this story, and from reading his biography, when he did Zebra, he was kind of in a little depressed place because he was in New York, and he didn't think he really fed in. You know, he didn't think he fit in, you know, into the New York flavor. You know what I'm saying? So I guess this is what came out of him. You know what I'm saying? And he eventually moved to LA, and I guess he started feeling the vibe from there. And then, you know, he was releasing music then, and then finally in 2016 he released his debut album. It was called Oleology. And I remember I was doing this podcast, and the host was actually telling me, yo, you need to check out Gallant's new album, I think you will really enjoy it. And I checked it out, and I never really got back to him, you know what I'm saying? Obviously. And you know, and I actually enjoyed the album, you know what I'm saying? He got a couple of songs that I liked on it. You hear Wait and Go. It was actually the single from the album. Shotgun, Bourbon, for many reasons. Episode, and I hope I'm pronouncing this right, is Mitakazi, if I'm saying it right, or yeah, I think that's how I'm saying it right. But that, and then Open Up. And that's crazy that I liked a lot of these songs, but I didn't talk about them on Current R&B Bangers. Like, I know I be talking about a lot of artists on Current R&B Bangers, but I do be missing some people, you know what I'm saying? But I'm gonna stop that, you know what I'm saying? Cause I need a team. That's another thing. I need a team to kind of help me, you know what I'm saying? Cause my brother, Sin, always helped me, sending me stuff and all this kind of stuff. But we need a team, you know what I'm saying? So if you got some new R&B artists, put me on, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, so I was just like, damn, I didn't talk about him. What's up with this? But finally, he released a new EP entitled Sleep On It. Sleep On It I don't know why I didn't talk about that joint, because I know I had that joint on my list to talk about, but I don't know why I didn't sleep on it. I love the record. It's so smooth. Love everything about it. Genuine is actually in the video and all that, but the song, because the EP Sleep On is only 3 songs, but it was one song that I cannot stop playing, and this joint is called Crimes, and it's so different, but it has that R&B and that rock edge that basically is Glon's influences, you know what I mean? And it also has like a gospel undertone to it, you know what I'm saying, with that piano. My mom calls it the funeral, you know what I'm saying, God please, that was my mama, not me, and she calls it, you know, the funeral piano, and for me it has that gospel in it, and I think it's dope, and I was like, I'm gonna talk about this joint on Crombie Bangers. I'm tired of missing out not talking about Galan on the show. So this joint is entitled Crimes, and here we go. It goes a little something like this. Here we go. Dope record, y'all.
I don't buy it, and honestly I can't keep overlooking all your crimes. Yours is mine, but you lie.
Woo!
You don't wanna hurt your pride, and honestly, I can't keep overlooking all your crimes.
He don't say crimes there, but I do. You know what I'm saying? It just felt like crimes needed to be there, so that's why I always say it when it comes to that. But yo, Galan's music is such a vibe. It's and I love how this generation now be like, it's a vibe. His music is really is a vibe. Like I said, his falsetto is nothing to play with either. You know what I'm saying? Check a lot of live performances, and he really be hitting them. He don't need no computers, no nothing, no lipping to hit these falsettos. He's really a singer, y'all. But yo, check out his new EP. It's entitled Sleep On It. Crimes is the second joint on it. Listen, Sleep On It. It's only 3 songs. 3 songs. So go listen to 3 songs. Tell me what you think in the more info box. But yo, Crimes is it. And that's why I had to talk about it. And that is the 5th joint on Current R&B Bangers. There you go, y'all. I gave y'all 5 dope joint representing the fellas this week. Let's go back to them. Robin Thicke with When You Love Someone, Calvin Richardson, Let Me Love Up On You, Stokely with She, Dayton James with Already Won, and Galant with Crimes. Like, y'all, I just gave y'all 5 dudes that really, really sing, and they really dope. You know what I'm saying? Like, when I'm looking under comments on YouTube, they like, we don't have no male singers no more. We don't got none of that. Yes, we do, y'all. I just gave y'all 5 dope joints that's representing the males out here, for real, that really can sing and all that good stuff. Let me tell you something, y'all. R&B music is out here, y'all. I know a lot of people feel like it's dead and it's not here, but thank God for the internet. We have the internet, y'all, and that's what's really helping R&B. You know what I'm saying? We got, again, you know, I got Soul. This is R&B, Rated R&B, Singers Room, Junior's World of Soul. We have so many people that really represent. You can go on SoundCloud. You can check out Audio Mac. All these different sites that really, you know, a lot of these artists put their music up. And I know it's hard because mainstream is not talking about those websites, but listen, they're out there, y'all, for real. And if you need any clarification, just come to Junior's World of Soul on YouTube and look at the playlist on how many artists I've talked about on Current R&B Bangers. I'm telling y'all, R&B is alive and well, and do not let them fool y'all. You know what I'm saying? I had to give y'all a quick little rant before I got out of here. But y'all know how I do. I love to come in with a new joint, but I love to end with a classic. This year, 53 years ago, this song was number 1 on the R&B charts, coming from one of the best male R&B groups of all time. I am talking about The Temptations, and we gonna go out with a classic that was written and produced by Norman Whitfield, and here we go.
Yeah. So if you're
but so untrue on the inside. I'm out, y'all. Peace.